हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट दी मॉड्यूल नंबर 1 फाउंडेशन इंजीनियरिंग। टॉपिक इज़ अ डीप फाउंडेशन। वी आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट दी शैलो फाउंडेशन एंड सब सरफेस इन्वेस्टिगेशन, एंड टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट दी डीप फाउंडेशन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज डीप फाउंडेशन? सो इफ द डेप्थ ऑफ द फाउंडेशन इज ग्रेटर देन द विड्थ ऑफ द फाउंडेशन इज कॉल अ डीप फाउंडेशन। डेप्थ ऑफ द फाउंडेशन एंड विड्थ रेशियो इज ग्रेटर देन द 4 to 5 meter। एंड हियर सम ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल फॉर द डीप फाउंडेशन इज अ पाइल फाउंडेशन, कैसन एंड अ वेल फाउंडेशन। सो इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड वी डिस्कस अबाउट द पाइल फाउंडेशन। सो वॉट इज पाइल? पाइल फाउंडेशन आर द पार्ट ऑफ दिस स्ट्रक्चर टू यूज टू कैरी द carry and transfer the load of structure on a ground. So here the main component of the pile foundation is a pile and second is a pile cap. Now when pile is used, so here two points pile is used. First is a good bearing capacity of the soil is not available, and second is the space restricted to allow spread footing. So in these two condition pile foundation is used. And where pile foundation is used? So stratum required bearing capacity at a greater depth. Next is a steep slope area. Third one is a high water table. Fourth one is a grillage or raft foundation are closed, are costly or impossible. Fifth one is a structure located near a river bank or a seashore. Sixth one is a canal or deep drainage line near the foundation. And seventh one is a not possible to timber trench for the excavation. So these, in this condition, pile foundation are required. So one by one we discuss about the type of pile based on function. So here total 8 type of the pile is available. First is a bearing pile, another name is a end bearing pile. Second one is a friction pile. Third one is a seat pile. Fourth one is a tension pile or uplift pile. Fifth one is a anchor pile. Sixth one is a batter pile. Seventh one is a fender pile. And eighth one is a compaction pile. So what is bearing pile or end bearing pile? So in this figure, end bearing pile or bearing pile is seen. So driven in a ground up to the hard stratum. So when we start the drilling the pile in a ground, so at the hard stratum pile is inserted in a ground and act as a pillar to transfer the load on a ground. So look like a one type of the column, circular column, and generally pile is in a circular shape. Next is a friction pile. So friction pile, as you seen in a figure, so when we insert a pile in a ground, so friction is generated on the surface of the pile. So generally friction pile driven in a soft soil. So pile is driven up to the such a depth that the friction develop at the both the side of the pile or periphery of the pile equal the load coming on a pile. So load carrying capacity of the friction pile increase by the four things. So first, increase the diameter of the pile. Second one is a driving the pile for a larger depth. Third one is a grouping of the pile, and fourth one is a making surface of the pile rough. So here see this figure. Here end bearing pile and friction pile both are seen. So in a end bearing pile, when we applied the load on the top of the pile surface, so in a end bearing pile upward pressure is generated, clear? And in a screen friction pile, when we applied the load on a top of the pile, so here screen friction is generated and upward load is decreased as compared to end bearing pile, because skin friction pile is generally used in a soft soil. नेक्स्ट इज अ सीट पाइल. सीट पाइल आर नेवर प्रोवाइडेड वर्टिकल सपोर्ट बट आर मोस्टली यूज एज अ रिटेनिंग वॉल एंड यूज फॉर द फॉलोइंग पर्पज. सो हियर फोर पर्पज वी यूज द सीट पाइल. सो फर्स्ट वन इज अ टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ रिटेनिंग वॉल और एनी अदर मरीन वर्क. सेकेंड इज अ टू प्रोटेक्ट द इरोजन ऑफ अ रिवर बैंक. एंड थर्ड वन इज अ रिटेन अ साइड ऑफ द फाउंडेशन ट्रेंच. एंड फोर्थ वन इज अ टू प्रोटेक्ट अ फाउंडेशन फ्रॉम द इरोजन. हियर फिगर शो द सीट पाइल. सो सीट पाइल जनरली प्रोवाइडेड एट द एंड और एट द पेरीफरी ऑफ द साइट. सो हियर इन दिस फिगर सीट पाइल इज फोर्सफुली इंसर्टेड इन अ ग्राउंड एंड बाय हैमरिंग और वाइब्रो हैमर सीट पाइल वॉल इज इंसर्टेड इन अ ग्राउंड. सो इन अ टॉप ऑफ द फिगर यू एग्जैक्टली सीन दी बाय वाइब्रो हैमरिंग. सो इन अ वाइब्रो हैमरिंग हैमर इज बाय यूजिंग द हैमर वी इंसर्ट द पाइल ऑन अ ग्राउंड. नेक्स्ट इज अ एंकर पाइल. सो पाइल आर प्रोवाइडेड टू एंकर अगेंस्ट द हॉरिजॉन्टल पुल. सो हियर इन एंकर पाइल सो वी ड्रिल द ग्राउंड इन अ वर्टिकली और डायगोनली एंड दिस ड्रिलिंग इज एंकर पाइल इज फिक्स एंड दिस एंकर इज फिक्स्ड विद अ रिटेनिंग वॉल और एनी कॉन्क्रीट वॉल. क्लियर. सो इन दिस फिगर नंबर टू एग्जैक्टली सीन दी एंकर पाइल. सो एंकर पाइल इन वर्टिकली एंड डायगोनली बोथ दी एट अ सम ऑफ द एंगल इंसर्टेड इन अ ग्राउंड एंड दिस एंकर पाइल इज जनरली मेड बाय द कॉन्क्रीट एंड एंकरिंग इन अ ग्राउंड बाय द कॉन्क्रीट पाइल. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज अ बेटर पाइल. सो द पाइल आर इंसर्टेड इंक्लाइंड टू रेजिस्ट द हॉरिजॉन्टल एज वेल एज इंक्लाइंड फोर्स. सो एज यू सीन द फिगर ग्रीन कलर इंक्लाइंड पाइल आर इंसर्टेड इन अ ग्राउंड. सो हियर जनरली यूज इन अ मरीन स्ट्रक्चर लाइक डॉक एंड हार्बर. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज अ फेंडर पाइल. सो द पाइल आर यूज टू प्रोटेक्ट द कॉन्क्रीट डैक और अदर वाटर फ्रंट स्ट्रक्चर फ्रॉम द एब्रेजन और इम्पैक्ट कॉजेज फ्रॉम द शिप. सो जनरली फेंडर पाइल इज ऑल्सो जनरली यूज इन अ वाटर स्ट्रक्चर एंड हियर इन अ फर्स्ट फिगर यू एग्जैक्टली सीन दी फेंडर पाइल. सो इन अ फेंडर पाइल वेन वी शिप इज पार्क एट अ वेन अ शिप इज पार्क एट अ फेंडर पाइल. सो जर्क ऑफ द शिप इज नॉट डैमेज द स्ट्रक्चर मरीन स्ट्रक्चर. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज अ कॉम्पैक्शन पाइल. सो वेन द पाइल ड्रिवन इन अ ग्रेन्युलर सॉइल विद द एम ऑफ इंक्रीज द बेरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द सॉइल द पाइल आर टर्म एज अ कॉम्पैक्शन पाइल. सो हियर फिगर शो द कॉम्पैक्शन पाइल. सो इन अ कॉम्पैक्शन पाइल फर्स्ट वी ड्रिल द सॉइल बाय द कटर. सो हियर इन अ फर्स्ट फिगर मशीन ड्रिल द सॉइल एंड क्लॉकवाइज स्पायरल कट द सॉइल एंड रिमूव द सॉइल इन अ सर्क्युलर फॉर्म. एंड देन आफ्टर इन अ फिगर नंबर थर्ड वी एग्जैक्टली सीन दी बाय द पंपिंग ऑफ द कॉन्क्रीट वी इंसर्ट द कॉन्क्रीट इन अ पाइल एंड अबव द वी प्रिपेयर द बेस ऑफ द कॉन्क्रीट वी यूज द स्टील बार टू गेट द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द कॉन्क्रीट एंड देन आफ्टर बाय फोर्सफुली अप्लाइड द स्टील बार इंसर्ट इन अ ग्राउंड एंड वी प्रिपेयर अ कॉम्पैक्शन पाइल. सो टाइप ऑफ पाइल बेस्ड ऑन मटेरियल. सो देर आर फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ द मटेरियल जनरली यूज इन अ पाइल. सो फर्स्ट इज अ टिम्बर पाइल, सेकंड वन इज अ कॉन्क्रीट पाइल, थर्ड वन इज अ कॉम्पोजाइट पाइल, फोर्थ वन इज अ स्टील पाइल एंड फिफ्थ वन इज अ सैंड पाइल. सो वन बाय वन वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ पाइल बेस्ड ऑन material. So first is a timber pile. So timber is a economical support lie structure, and generally sal, teak, devdar, babul and khair wood is used in a timber pile. So khair wood pile used in a sea area because khair wood is not damaged by the sea water. Now circular or a square shape in a section generally used in a timber pile. So pile driven in a ground by the pile driving equipment, and generally by hammering we insert the pile in a ground. So pile head is provided at the top of the pile, and at the lower end pile is provided by cast iron or conical shape. So why conical shape or cast iron shape is provided at the end of the pile? Because easily insert in a ground. Means one type of the soil is provided at the bottom of the pile, and the best spacing between the two pile are 90 cm center to center. So from the circular pile, like a circular square pile, from the center to center distance generally required is 90 cm, and maximum load carrying capacity of the timber pile is 20 ton. And if timber pile is circular shape, so generally diameter of the timber pile is 30 cm to 50 cm, and length of the timber pile should not be more than 20 times of the cross sectional dimension. So what is 20 times of the cross sectional dimension? Means if your diameter of the pile is 30 cm, so means your pile length is 20 times of the 30 cm, means 20 multiplied by 30 means 600 cm maximum length is required. Next is the advantages of the timber pile. So here economical, because in India timber is easily available. Second one is driven easily. So in a timber pile, no any extra equipment is required, so it's easily driven in a ground, and does not need any heavy machinery and easy to handle, because timber pile is light in weight as compared to concrete or steel pile, and easily withdraw. Generally in a withdrawal timber pile, so by using the machinery we easily withdraw. Next is a disadvantages of the timber pile. So salt water or insect affect the pile. So these disadvantage, generally timber pile is not used in a sea area and restricted in a length, because generally we are not using the large size of the timber, and we are not getting the large size of the timber pile. Now next is a not durable material. So it is easily damaged material and impossible to deliver in a hard stratum, because as compared to steel pile, timber is very soft material, and low bearing capacity timber pile is used in a low bearing capacity. In a high bearing capacity timber pile is not used. Next is a concrete pile. So concrete pile is divided into three part. First is a precast concrete pile, second one is a cast in situ concrete pile, third one is a pre-stressed concrete pile. So one by one we discuss about the this concrete pile. So precast concrete pile. So precast concrete pile generally in a circular, square or rectangular in shape, and cast in a factory and transported on a site. So here name indicate precast, means in a precast generally concrete is cast in a factory, and then after by using the transportation system we easily transport the pile on a site. And then after, if the space are available, then cast near the site. So we cast the concrete pile on site, and driven by the pile driving equipment, and diameter varies from the 35 to 65 cm, and the length of the pipe is 4.5 m to 30 m, depend on a diameter. And reinforcement usually in a precast concrete pile is usually 30 to 50 mm in a diameter, and floor stirrups generally use 60 to 10 mm diameter. So here stirrup is provided in a compulsory stirrup is provided in a precast concrete pile. So here figure, so the precast concrete pile, and by hammering concrete pile is inserted in a ground. So here precast concrete pile, first small drilling is required on a ground, and then after we first we insert a small part of the pile on a ground, and then after by using the hammer we insert the by using the hammering we insert the pile on a ground. So here compulsory in a machinery ladder pole is required to guide the hammer and pile in a into the vertical position. If ladder pole is slightly inclined, so pile driven in a ground is slightly inclined, or at a some of the angle pile is inserted. So it is compulsory required to ladder pole to guide the hammer. Now next is the advantages of the precast concrete pile. So very effective, simple quality control, and improve the entire area in a precast concrete pile. And here some of the disadvantages also in a precast concrete pile. So limited in length, difficult in transportation, and required costly equipment, and not suitable for a densely built up area. So here one of the videos show to you on a pile driven ground by hammering. You exactly seen the in a pile driving equipment. Here in a pile driving equipment, ladder pole like this red color vertical post is show the ladder pole, and generally used to guide the hammer. Here hammer is lift up and down, and by forcefully concrete pile is inserted in a ground. So you exactly seen the by the hammering, by forcefully hammering, pile is easily inserted in a ground. So this video show the circular pile is inserted in a ground. Now next is a cast in situ concrete pile. So in a cast in situ concrete pile, cast the concrete pile on a ground. So in a cast in situ pile, bore is dug by the drill a casting pipe into the ground, and soil is removed and casting is filled up by the concrete. So here two types of the cast in situ concrete pile. Caged cast in situ concrete pile is the metallic shell is left inside the ground along with the core, and uncaged in a situ concrete pile, so metallic shell is withdrawn. So advantages of the cast in situ concrete pile: no limited in a length, and required less equipment, and cost is less. And some of the disadvantages of the cast in situ concrete pile is a quality control is difficult, and screen fixation resistance is low. So here in a figure cast in situ concrete pile. So in a first figure, so the first we drill the concrete pile, drill the soil to insert a concrete pile. So first, after drilling, steel is inserted in a concrete pile drilling, and then after concrete is filled up in a hole. Clear? So these are the cast in situ concrete pile. So here in a second on-site photo scene. So in a on-site photo you easily see. So here concrete is filled up in a pile by the RMC truck. So directly RMC truck concrete is filled up. And from in a second figure you saw the top of the concrete pile. So in a top of the concrete pile you easily seen the inserted steel rod with a stirrups is inserted in a ground, and after inserted in a ground concrete is filled up. So these are the